All right. Well, welcome to another Earnest report. This is February 6th, 2017, and this is the first Earnest financial report. So basically what I wanted to do is address some kind of issues with transparency, basically disclose my finances to folks that are, in particular, those who contribute to my GoFundMe campaign, and to many other folks who help provide me with housing and meals while I'm out here in Northwest Arkansas. So this is just my first attempt at sharing my expenses with people and sharing why I'm sharing my finances. I'm a firm believer in cooperative governance and democratic governance, and part of working cooperatively and being democratic, I feel, is also being transparent. So since I'm using people's money to do the work that I get invited to do, I just wanted to share with everybody what those finances look like, and so, and what my future plans are as well. So let's get started. What exactly are my finances? So I just covered why I disclose my finances. So now I'd like to basically talk about what my finances exactly are. What are my expenditures? And for quite a while, for almost a decade, so about 10 years ago, when I first started working on my ecological footprint, I quickly realized that there's a direct correlation to your income and your ecological footprint. The higher your income, the larger your ecological footprint. So over the last 10 years, I've really been working on how do I live in a manner that has the lowest income possible in order to decrease my ecological footprint by the most possible. And basically, that led me into a path of agriculture where I can live and work cooperatively on farms and not really work or live in a manner that requires a lot of vehicle transportation. And so for almost 7 years now, I've maintained an income underneath $10,000 a year. Sometimes I'm an independent contractor, sometimes I'm an employee, but always I'm working and living in kind of the same cooperative environment. Whether it's an intentional community or a group work environment, or even living in a multi-family household. So now that I'm traveling a lot, the type of expenses that I usually have are mostly associated with travel. One of the things that I do actually is help other people lower their footprint. So the more people that stay in a house together, that take care of the dishes and the cooking and everything in the house together, the easier it is on everybody. The more time I think is usually spent in the household environment as opposed to maybe going out places. And of course, I don't own a house. And so that footprint of me creating this brand new house will never happen. The more I can live and work cooperatively. So I do help with gas for a lot of the folks that end up driving me around. I try to help with food. I've also donated some money to some of the fundraisers out here, and that's one of the things that I actually like doing with the contributions that go to my GoFundMe campaign, is when I have opportunities to give money to local organizations. I like to do that even if it's a small amount. I always prefer to give my money to people instead of corporations. So I'm always cognizant of that as I'm spending other people's money. Another expense, let's see, a few personal expenses. I don't really need to buy any new things. I've actually live out of basically a backpack and a carry-on bag. So to maintain the things that I own and that I'm traveling with really doesn't cost very much. So those are mostly my finances. And then also there's finances that's usually associated with projects that I might be involved in. And usually that's one of the reasons why I try to help some of the local folks in this area with creating the space for their event or help them clean up after their space after an event. The bus cooperative, I just wanted to point out that if the bus cooperative kind of continues and becomes a community project that people want to get involved with, then I will be disclosing the, or recommend to disclose the bus cooperative finances in very much the same way that I'm disclosing my finances now. And so the bus cooperative will actually be a separate project from my personal GoFundMe campaign, but we'll see how that kind of evolves depending on people's needs later on. I will enter in, so I'll talk more about exact numbers here shortly, but basically I'll be entering in my receipts to a Google document, which will be public. It'll be posted in the show notes or the description of this video so that people can link to it. I have about $250 of receipts that I've kept track of. There's probably been another $100 in meals or highway tolls that I've incurred that I haven't been very good at keeping the receipts for, some gas fill-ups. There's there was a $50 bus ticket to get out here to Arkansas, and I've also kind of just donated almost $100 in cash to either different groups or people that have helped me out. And I don't really keep track of the donations, like it's going to be an itemized kind of entry, you know, in when I do my taxes next year. For those that are curious how taxes and whatnot work for the GoFundMe stuff that I'm doing, I am basically, GoFundMe provides me with a 1099 at the end of the year based on the amount of money that's gone through the GoFundMe campaigns. So I basically file as an independent contractor, and things like health insurance really just come down to the state that I'm living in. And currently I'm still qualified in Ohio for health care. So if I get really sick, I can go get health care as long as I can get to Ohio. Good thing I know some herbalists, wonderful herbalists out here in Arkansas. So I like to consider gardens my kind of health care. This is getting off topic now. Let's see. So I'll link back, I'll put a link to the actual spreadsheet that'll have these finances kind of written down. Too many ums. My long-term schedule, I thought I'd also kind of update people, so especially those that contribute to my campaign or host me while I'm traveling. My long-term plan is to definitely be in Arkansas through to the end of March. I do have an offer to work at a Mountain Garden Herbs in North Carolina, and assist them with some things and learn myself how to grow medicine, and in particularly Chinese herbs. And that, not sure when that will start, but I will be have an invitation to go there anytime after March. And also really high on my radar is the Pine Ridge Permaculture Convergence at the end of July. And I've actually been asked to teach and help facilitate or help with the organization of the event, getting, you know. So I'm going to try to be out at the Pine Ridge Indian Reservation in South Dakota July 1st at the latest. I'd actually like to be out there sooner than that to help with things on the ground. It'll also give me an opportunity, depending on the what's happening out at Standing Rock, to travel from Standing Rock and help with the permaculture convergence if I can be up there in the summer. And I'm not sure how that will affect with Mountain Garden Herbs or what. Maybe I'll travel back out there after the permaculture convergence, or maybe I'll travel to another pipeline. Maybe spend a month in North Carolina, kind of process things as they unfold in our society and help them, and then start traveling again and raising awareness about the dangers of continuing this mad dash to extract and make as much money as possible off of fossil fuels. So none of this is paid work. All of it is just work that needs to be done, I feel, and other people feel. And I am lucky enough to be mobile. I'm lucky enough to be patient and lucky enough to wake up every day excited about the many uncertainties that are always in my life. And so with the generous kind of support through my GoFundMe, I'm pretty much expecting expenses of around $500 a month or so, and pretty happy that I can have an income this year, essentially $6,000 a year, and share pretty much everything, you know, everything. I have a backpack and stuff that's mine, but everything that else that I come in contact with is somebody else's. So it's been very interesting. Very hard for me to stay on task, as you know, if you've seen any of my other videos. So that's my long-term schedule. I kind of look at it, you know, in the winter I'll be here, maybe in the spring in Mountain Gardens, or still here. If the bus cooperative happens, I've pretty much agreed to be available for first three months of the bus cooperative. So if that happens, I'll definitely be here for another 3 months. Hopefully we'll have the pipeline stopped by then. And of course, not only do I want to thank my GoFundMe family and everybody that spends time watching any of my videos, but I'd also like to thank the many people that I meet, that take me to lunch, that allow me to sleep on their couch or in their spare rooms, and just all the exciting people that are getting involved in their community. I was at a Food Not Bombs meeting yesterday. That would be Sunday, the 5th. And lots of people there had been in Food Not Bombs groups in the past, but half of the people that were there were just folks that are tired of just going to work and coming home and sitting on the couch, and they want to get involved in their community and they want to feed people, and they know that if we're not talking about the violence and the war and the bombs, then we're not really having very deep discussions. So I want to thank everybody, and hope if that this provides a kind of clear or not too fuzzy explanation of my finances, how I'm spending other people's money, and what I have opportunities to do in the future. Kind of depends on what other people want me to do. So I appreciate any comments that you can leave on the YouTube videos, or message me through Facebook or Twitter. And hope everybody out there is having a good time and a good day. So thank you, and this is another Earnest Report.